Jason here again, and I'm actually officially starting, I guess, my podcast or vlogging. I might take the audio and make it a podcast, but I think doing the videos is kind of where I'm at, kind of like this feel. So I hope that y'all enjoy this and plan on kicking it with me. So, you know, a few months ago, you all that follow me on Instagram know that I posted a question, which I rarely do, and I asked about, you know, if I started a podcast or whatever, what would y'all like me to talk about? And I got quite a few responses that were great. Like, everything y'all want me to talk about, I think is great. And I just, you know, pray and hope that everything that y'all want me to talk about, that I do it justice. So that's my thing. So I guess kind of to start this thing off, you know, there was one in particular that I saw that someone asked, and they said, what drives you to follow your calling? And that's such, man, that is so huge. And I really wanted to start with this one because I just finished this book called Better Than You Can Imagine. And in the book, they talk about how we all have a unique need or a unique thing in us to fulfill a need. And it's just a matter of tapping into it. There's something that God in there says that there are some areas or some things where God will put a little bit extra in us to fulfill a need in someone else. And then there are areas that he puts a little less in us, that he puts more in someone else, that they can help facilitate that, you know, basically under the premise of building community and relationships. So in just finishing that book and really looking into the details of what the book was talking about and just understanding that there's something in me, I think that's one of the greatest things that drives me to follow my calling. You know, by nature, I am an introvert and a really shy person, but a wise man once told me that if God can get it through you, he'll get it to you. And that was so huge to me, because as a musician, you know, when I was asking God, I was praying, I was like, Lord, I really want to be able to tour. That's a dream of mine. I really started to see that come to pass. It was like, if God could get it through me, he would get it to me. And I realized the more open doors and opportunities that he gave me to tour and to gig and to record and all of those different things musically, the more I was finding myself using that platform or using those opportunities to bless others, especially musicians. You know, I would get hit up, you know, in my inbox and all kind of stuff where people were asking like, hey man, how do I get to your level and get to doing what you're doing now? Mind you, I'm sitting here like, I'm not doing anything, because I felt like although I was doing stuff, there was more that I wanted to do. But in my quest to gain more, I wasn't taking the time to enjoy what I had. And so while someone else is looking like, I'm just trying to get to where you're at, I'm like, oh yeah, I ain't doing nothing. Like, this ain't even it. But if I was doing something and God was blessing me, and it wasn't that I was ungrateful, it was just the hunger and drive to get to better was overshadowing the fact that I had made progress somewhere, that I was reaching goals, that I was hitting milestones. And we should learn to always take the time to pause and enjoy where we're at while not getting comfortable and being satisfied, still having that hunger and thirst to get to greater, but taking the time to appreciate what we have accomplished. And so when people were asking me, it just would do something for me, you know, to be able to help someone, you know, help somebody get in on an endorsement that I had, or, you know, be able to throw gigs to someone else that you know, was new in the area, or, you know, just really trying to get their feet wet in the game, you know, just understanding that, you know, no matter how small or insignificant what I had, I thought was, it was big to someone else. And then even if it was small, it was still enough to provide for someone else, you know. Even thinking about you, just the little bit that you have, you know, again, reminds me, you know, I posted a video last week, and it just reminds me again of like learning to value what God values, right? Like, don't devalue what God values. So even though it was little, like the widow woman, she only had enough left to make a little cake for her and her son. And she was going to do that, eat it, and prepare to die. And it was like that little bit, God took that little bit that she thought was insignificant. And not only did it feed her and her son, but it fed the prophet. And then she didn't die. She had more than enough. And I had to realize in my own life that the things that I was accomplishing, that in the grand scheme of things to me seemed minor, be in retrospect to the things that I wanted over here, or that I seen other people doing, like you're gigging or you're touring with this person, but you want the A-list artist. And so down here, it kind of seems insignificant. And it's like, nah, even that small thing, what I had to learn was it wasn't really small. It was just my perspective. But God was using that to allow me to bless the masses, like to bless people all over the world. Literally, I've had the opportunity to travel all over the world. And I think that my process and these things had to happen the way that they happened for me to learn to appreciate and to not to minimize and not to value, to devalue the things that God values, the things that God value me enough to give me these chances or these opportunities, these blessings, you know. And so just learning to no matter how small it is, it still can make a huge impact. The faith the size of a mustard seed, which you've ever seen one, is super tiny, can move big mountains. So God is constantly reminding us that it doesn't take a whole lot. It could be a little bit, but that can produce one apple seed, can produce an entire apple tree that will produce thousands to hundreds of thousands of apples in its lifetime. And so learning to value the small things, the small beginnings, man, it is something. There is something about the journey. A lot of times we're so interested in the destination that we forget to enjoy the journey. And sometimes it's just something to be said about small beginnings. You know, you get to have the pleasure of enjoying that journey instead of starting at the top. I get to enjoy and all of the lessons that I get to learn along the way. It's all about perspective. And so when asked what really, you know, fueled me to, or to give me the desire to go after my calling or to pursue my calling, I believe it's people, like people, you all that will sit here and watch this video. It's you that drive me. It's the joy that's set before me. You know, I'm able to endure whatever it takes to pursue the calling. It's for my family. It's understanding my why, understanding that my calling is bigger than me. It's bigger than you know, anything that is just, it's bigger than self-consumption. It's bigger than my own comfort or my own gain. It's about what I'm doing for others. It's about the world around me that I'm impacting. And even if it's just one of you, it's still bigger. That's still bigger than me. If I can encourage anyone through my life, through me being vulnerable, through me sharing not only my successes, but even my failures or even things that I struggle with, if that can help you be a better person, if that can help you get over your fears, if that can help you drive you a little more, cause you to now go after your calling because you understand that it's bigger than you. You know, Jesus didn't have to die for us. He did no wrong. He was good. He was already in heaven with the Father. He was good. He could have just left us to ourselves, but he understood that it was bigger than him. So he endured the cross, you know. And for many of us, it's sometimes it is a huge, it can be an inconvenience to go after destiny, to go after the things that God called you to do, to pursue a passion, to pursue purpose. Sometimes that is, many times it can be an inconvenience, but it's worth it. It'll be better than you could ever imagine. So the joy that I get out of just my friends or people that have access to me, like my phone number and things, that will text me or call me like, hey man, can I talk to you? Or, you know, or sitting in a restaurant or somewhere, when we could sit in restaurants, we can't sit in them anymore, but when we could, or, you know, church, wherever, you know, just sitting with people and just having a good conversation where we're talking about these things and really talking about, you know, just life in general and whatever wisdom that I can share, man. I feel like that's what drives me to pursue or go after my calling. It's like just the people that I can impact, the people that I can touch, the people whose lives that I can change. I'm a drummer, and you just never know the impact on a kid that after a show, you go take them a pair of drumsticks. You know, that's huge. You know, and I'm able to do that because I'm walking in my calling. You know, that's part of my calling as a musician. You know, I had the opportunity to go to Africa, and I never forget when we went out there, we were like, it's not just about us doing music, but we wanted to impact that community. And so we took drumsticks, drum heads, guitar strings, bass guitar strings. We took two electric guitars and I think an acoustic that we took for the purposes of giving away. And I never forget, there was a kid that I gave, I literally gave out all of my drumsticks, like all of my personal drumsticks, like everything that I own. I flew back to America with no drumsticks. Like, I'm gonna have to land and buy sticks. I gave away them all. And I never forget, there was one kid in particular that wanted drumsticks, and I gave him a pair of drumsticks, and his mother came up to me and was like, thank you so much for doing this, you know, for my kid. And what to us is like, you know, everyday, you know, not even, we don't even see it as a luxury that we can go to Guitar Center or Sam Ash or whatever music store and buy gear. They don't even have access to those kind of things. So to someone else, a pair of drumsticks isn't nothing. But to that kid, it meant everything. It wasn't just about the drumsticks. It's now the value that is placed on him. Like, someone thinks enough of me to who I'm looking up to as like a celebrity. They were treating us like we were superstars. You know, someone that I'm looking to as a celebrity stopped long enough to see me and give me a pair of sticks. Now that just encourages that kid so much. And it's the feeling of being able to impact someone's life. You know, even like that for someone else might look small. Like, that's why I go after my calling. And it's really about understanding your why. Like, why? Why do you exist? Why are you here? Why did God give you these gifts and talents? Like, what's your why? What wakes you up every morning? What drives you? What makes you want to sit and write a lyric, a verse, a chorus, a rap, a book, a novel? Like, what makes you want to hit record and record a mini documentary, a interview, a vlog like I'm doing right now? What makes you want to do, what drives you to do the things that you really feel passionate about or that you're called to? And that's what you pull from. You know, that's, for me, that's what it was for me. It's like, again, I'm an introvert. I'm not really one that wants to sit around and be in the limelight and talk and all of those kind of things. But I understand that it's bigger than me. And once I get over me and my fears and my, you know, like, oh, I'm not good enough. And when I get over all of that, you know, the end result, what it does for others is what matters to me. It is so huge. And so even now doing this, you know, people have been asking me, like, yo, man, when you going to start? When you going to start? And I've been sitting around like, I don't got no sweet name for it. I still don't have a name for it, but I'm still going to make these videos. You know, I'm still going to make the videos. I have them ready. I'll edit them. They'll be ready to go. I'm going to do it. Like I owe it to everyone that believes in me, to everyone that has pushed me, to everyone that has invested in me. I owe it to God. I owe it to myself. I owe it to my family to be the highest version of myself possible and to be that example. Like, I can't push you and ask you to do something and then I don't do it. And so me doing this is that example. Like, even when you don't feel like you're good enough, or will people watch, or will people subscribe, like, do it anyway. Do it anyway, because you have it in you to do. And it's not about, even if one person does, then that's the person that should be impacted. And it could be that one person that is impacted that you may never meet, that the way you have changed the whole course of their life because you obeyed, because you pursued your calling, because you walked in your calling. Like, that for me is all I needed. It's huge. And I just constantly remind myself of that. Like, man, you can't stop. Like, you got to keep pursuing. You got to keep walking in it, because someone needs it. Someone needs it. And as much as someone might need it, I realize that I need it too. It needs me and I need it. And so I go after it. So, you know, we're going to do this. We'll walk through this thing called life together. That's my thing. Again, I'll have a lot of my friends and as many people as I can get on, however I can get them on. But, you know, and we're going to talk about everything from spiritual things, from the Bible, from ministry to music to gigging and how I got on gigs and, you know, how I balance gigging with ministry to everything that y'all asked me about. I had a few people ask me about dating and relationships, and we'll talk about that too. I'll give my take on that. I'm not perfect as it relates to what drove me to walk in my calling. You know, it's you guys. It's everyone around me. It's the people that I see that are doing it, that are walking in their calling, that encourage me every day to get up, get out of the bed, and pursue it with all diligence. So thanks to everyone. Thanks to you all, you know, because if it wasn't for people around me pushing me, I probably would not be doing this. So yeah, that's my why. Like, that's my why, really. That's my why. It's the world around me. It's the people that, you know, what if I don't say yes to this? What if I didn't say yes? Who would miss out? Who would be stuck in the wilderness because of my lack of obedience, you know? And so that's my thing. It's going to be really, you know, informal. So I pray that this just bless you. And we will see you on the next episode. Yeah, by the way, you know, I'm trying to get my YouTube up. So, you know, if you like the content, the vlogs, like, share, please subscribe, you know, and I'm going to keep bringing these videos and contents. Also, you can put in there anything that you would like us to talk about, or you want to hear, or, you know, my perspective on a thing, you know, whatever, what kind of music I like, whatever, you know, drop that in the comments as well. And we will see you soon. Have a great day. Peace.